Good morning, children. Today we are going to learn about the matter and its components. Matter is anything that occupies space and has mass. Now, the smallest unit of matter is atom. Any matter we take, the smallest unit is always atom. If these atoms of same kind join together, they form a molecule of an element. If the atoms of different kind join together, they form molecule of a compound. We'll come back to this later. Let's first understand the structure of an atom. Now here, look carefully. An atom has a nucleus. This nucleus has positively charged protons. These have a positive charge on them. And neutrons, they do not have any charge. Okay, they are chargeless, so I am not putting any charge here. Now this nucleus is surrounded by a shell, and in these shell, like the planets orbit around sun, similarly these electrons, they orbit around the nucleus. Electrons are negatively charged particles. Okay, so in the structure of atom, there is a tightly packed nucleus which has no charged neutrons, positively charged protons, and on the outer shell in an orbit rotate or revolve the electrons which are negatively charged. Now, whenever an atom is undergoing a chemical change, only the electrons can be gained or lost. Okay, so if the electron is lost, the number of protons increases. If the electron is gained, the number of protons decreases. Now, how it decreases? In any atom, number of protons is equal to number of electrons is equal to number of neutrons. Okay, so whenever there is more number of electrons, the atom gets a negative charge. When there are more number of protons, the atom gets a positive charge. But this gaining or losing of charge is dependent upon the number of electrons lost or gained. Let's move further to molecules. Now, molecules are the smallest unit of any matter that can exist independently. Okay, while the atoms cannot exist independently, the molecules can. Okay, now molecules, as we studied, if the molecules are having atoms of same kind, O2, it has two atoms of oxygen, it is a molecule of an element. H2, it has atoms of same element, and so it is an element. Whereas in case of H2O, it has two hydrogen and one oxygen. So this is a compound. We'll understand what is a compound in the next step. I hope this thing is clear to you. The molecules are the smallest unit that can exist independently, whereas the atoms are the smallest unit of any matter that is found. It is indivisible part of any atom, any element. Now let's come to matter. Matter can be divided into pure substance and mixture. Pure substance can be further divided into elements and compounds. Elements are those molecules which are having atoms of same kind, whereas compounds are those molecules which are having atoms of more than one element combined in a fixed ratio. Okay, so here if you see, I have written H2O, and here also I have written H2O, because the formula of water is 2 hydrogen combined with 1 oxygen, and we get H2O, which is formula for water. Okay, similarly, if we look here, there is C, which is carbon, O, which is oxygen. If we combine, we get CO2. Wherever we take the sample of carbon dioxide, it will always have a molecular formula of CO2. The composition does not change. In case of mixtures have no fixed proportion or no fixed composition and can have any amount of any element combined in them. A very simple example can be, whenever you make tea or you make lemon water, we can add as many amount of sugar we want to, right? And this mixture can be, each element of this mixture can be tasted. We can taste water in lemon water, we can taste salt in lemon water, we can taste sugar and even lemon. All four components of the mixture can be felt, and so in mixture all the components, they show their own properties. Okay. Thank you.